stretch by Mainu. Palmer's able to take up possession of the ball. Palmer, lovely ball to Watkins inside the area. Watkins, oh, he scored! Watkins from an impossible angle across Verbruggen and into the far bottom corner. What a strike that is from Ollie Watkins!
Well, this is a bit awkward. Hello, everybody. Welcome to episode 153 of the Just Passing Through podcast. I'm here in Japan, having just spent 24 hours getting the foot right out of my mouth. We'll just have a quick one today because I think I need to apologise. What did we start with that? Podcast, the eternal quarterfinalers. Now, I've just watched Holland England game. Now, I watched the first half, the second half. I got up early for it. I thought I'd honestly jinxed myself with getting up early and watching it. You know, my hopes were raised. Now, halfway through the second half, I had to start working online, so I had the telly on and I had one eye on game. Saka scored, it were offside, and then Ollie Watkins steps up and scores that 90th minute winner. And here we are, after all my negativity and all my worrying, here we are in final. I don't know how we've got here. Everybody were calling for Gareth said at the start of the qualifying games, the group games, the saying get him out, he's shite. And here we are in final. I have not seen England win out in my entire lifetime. The last Euros, when we got to the final, I subscribed to a British VPN company. I then got up early in the morning to watch England v Italy. The VPN didn't fucking work. So I completely missed that entire final. So I can honestly say I have never ever seen England play in any sort of final in my life. I've seen them lose in a couple of semi-finals, but this is the first time I've ever seen them this is going to be the first time I ever see him in a final. What am I worried about? Obviously, being an Englishman, being a Yorkshireman, you can't get your hopes up. And I have allowed myself to get a little bit positive halfway through. Let me think. Half time of the Holland game. That's when I started to think, I think we're all right here. But, you know, as soon as I switched it on and Holland go 1-0 up, well, here we go. I mean, it were a cracking strike and Jordan Pickford did get his fingers to it. I'll give him that. He did get his fingers to it, but it went straight in. Kane, that wasn't a penalty. It wasn't a penalty by any stretch of the imagination. But finally, after all these fucking years, we start getting, you know, questionable decisions going our way. I mean, if you look back, for fuck's sake, just let's look back at it, shall we? Beckham getting sent off in the 1998 World Cup. Diego Simeone making the most of that. That shouldn't have happened. Sol Campbell scoring a goal in that very same game. The ref disallows it. Nobody hears the whistle. The ball goes upfield and we have to go and defend that while we're still celebrating. Frank Lampard, 2010 against Germany. That ball was so over the fucking line. It was like making a racist joke in a Southern Baptist church. It was so over the line. So don't come at me with your 66 World Cup. That did go our way, even though that possibly might have been on the line. But finally, we start getting decisions going our way. And they did look better. I mean, you would, as with life, I say, if your life's going to be good and shit, you want it to be shit at the start and flourish towards the end. You don't want it going other way, otherwise you're just fucked. So like this tournament, England started off fucking garbage. Slovakia, garbage. We get into this Holland game. And as soon as we get halfway through, 20 minutes through that first half, you can see these little triangles appearing. And they're just pinging it between them. And Holland were letting us play, which they shouldn't really have done. But we just look better. He's got them working as Gareth now. Foden, you know, he curled one in and it come off at post. There were so many positives to come out of it. And it were great to see him play like that. To see him finally, all that talent on pitch, to see him working together. And that's what's going to kill me, I think. You know, Spain have won every single game they've played in. They've won all six games. No team in the history of the Euros has gone through all their games and won them all. Now, Spain are due a bad un, and we're due a good un. That is how I'm pinning my hopes on it. because I think everybody around the world is pinning Spain as the favourites, apart from the folk that live in England and the expats that are dotted all around the world. Everybody is thinking Spain, these are the team. But, this is the but, we're the underdog. We're hungry for it, I think. I think we're hungry for it. And we're starting to click. And that's what's making me think, is this it? Is this finally going to be it? Am I going to taste that sweet water that I've been wanting to bathe in my entire life? And I'm going to be up. I'm going to get up at 3:30 on Monday morning. I'm going to plonk myself down in front of my telly downstairs. And I'm going to watch it. It's a national holiday here in Japan on Monday. I don't know if they're giving it in anticipation of England playing. No, they're not. It's already penciled in as a national holiday here. I can't travel up to Tokyo and watch it because I'm working online at 8 o'clock. Now, I could go to Yokohama and watch it, but if it goes into extra time and it goes to penalties, I'm not going to be able to get back home for 8 o'clock to work. So I'm thinking I'm just going to stay put. I rang around a few of my friends that live in Zushi. There are no other Brits I know here that would be prepared to watch it together. So I'm going to watch it with all my friends, which means I'm going to be by myself. England, Spain, 4 o'clock in the morning, Monday. I don't know, I'm 50-50. I'm 50-50. Spain are just clicking like a team that are probably going to win it. England, they've put the foot on accelerator now. I think it's going to be a fucking great game. A great game. And I just want it, just this one England. If you get knocked out in the group games for the rest of my life, I don't care. I don't care. Just do this for me, will you please? Just for me. Just so I can see what my French friend went through, Fred. So I can see what my German friend, Ringo, went through. So I can see what the Spanish friends that I made when I was living over there. I mean, I was in Spain when the Spanish won the 2010 World Cup in South Africa. And they went fucking bananas. It was one of the best nights of my life. The whole fucking country coming together and going fucking crazy. It was great. Now, if England win it, I'm not going to get that because I'm not in England. But I just want that fucking feeling. Just for once. Just for once in my life. That's all I'm after. Now, I'm not sure whether I'm going to podcast from downstairs while game's on. I don't know if I'm going to do a post reaction yet. I've not decided. I might see if I can get some people online, but we'll see where we go from there. Fingers crossed, everybody. I'm not going to say adios. Goodbye, farewell, see you on Monday.
Cause it seems in all the snow.